Hello, buenas. Chris Hadfield here. This message goes out to Raj, Tyler, and Jim, the artist formerly known as Gareth. When I was on PR, I met your friend and mine, the Griddler, the Invisible Wizard. Now I have a challenge for you lads. I want you to write him a song for his birthday. Make it really good. Make it of epic proportions. I can't be a part of it because I'm back on the ISS over and over my own country, South Africa. So Griddler, happy birthday, Buana. Happy birthday, mate. Good luck, lads. Make me proud.
Are you mad?
This is not right.
My shot.
Oh shit.
Should have got more, shouldn't
I? I heard that you're slowing down, that you're losing hair, cause you're 50 now.
Nothing rhymes with Arduino.
Arduino. Arduino.
I was thinking.
Wait. What?
My laptop.
Oh, it's not a laptop. Sorry.
Burnin Pon in the morning. Arsenal tonight. Guard by shirt in the afternoon. And I had the test hat on right.
Set. Here we go. One, two, three, four.
I'm burning home. I burned my pony. I used to be an old diggy pony.
All the criddlers right here, right now. How do we know?
Jimmy Savile.
Wanna know what crid is? Like you don't know me. Yeah. Well, I miss my friend Creed. It's like you don't know me. Young children, now it's time to hear the tale of the Criddler we all know and love. With his legend, you'll be regaled. Duh.
'Twas winter time, and our hero was flying across the land. Smite a fire-breathing dragon and take the maiden's hand. He took a blast right in the arse, so he flew away and hid. The dragon went away that day in search of the man called Crid.
Wait, no, no, no. That is not how it happened. Look, I wasn't there, but legend has it that there was this ogre and his evil by association child causing a ruckus and just generally being unpleasant. This is how it went.
it's autumn now and the leaves are brown. The critter pit in town. Saw a crazy ogre there. He swore to take him down. Stuck into the monster's den and he fought it on his kill. The ogre cried that day from the stink dealt by the crib.
No. What, an ogre? No, and an ogre's kid? No. I think you'll find it wasn't actually an autumn. I think what you'll actually find is it happened a little bit more like this.
T'was springtime and a normal guy walked into the hood. He saw some local ne'er-do-wells thieving all the wood. He hoped that they would put it back. To his surprise, they did. The people of the hood stayed warm that night, all because of Creed.
No. What are you talking about? People in the hood, in springtime, needing wood to keep warm or something. That's not what happened at all. I was there. I was there that night. I know. The man behind the myth.
T'was summertime and Christian was camping on Andy's lawn. We stayed up late, found a lumber crate, and we partied until dawn. He woke Gronya in the tent. Poor Raj, he got the blame. From then on, like a burning pond, visible it became.